BBC Audio presents Myths Reimagined, a collection of acclaimed radio retellings of Greek and Roman myths by Andrew Rissik. The Troy Trilogy tells the tragic, timeless tale of events leading up to and following the fall of Troy. The trilogy starts with King Priam and his sons, where a son is being born to the king and his wife, but the gods foretell disaster if he is allowed to live.
Hour before dawn. A time when dreams are as drowsy as nectar, as sweet as honey. In the sky the stars are fading as the light grows. But Hecabe, queen of Troy, King Priam's wife, does not stir from her deep slumber. Dreams fall upon her as she sleeps, like dew upon the morning grass. Her eyes, fluttering beneath their lids, throng with images which only the gods or their messenger, Hermes, the bringer of dreams, can make sense of. In a matter of hours, Hecabe will be delivered of a second child, a second son. Yet she takes no joy in the life swelling in her womb and longing to be born. Her heart weeps because the child's father, her husband Priam, who built this great city, does not love her. Even in sleep, her spirit cries out to heaven for heaven's justice. I am Hermes, the son of Zeus and the goddess Maya. I come out of the air like fire or thought to serve the gods, of whom no testimony exists beyond the minds of mortal men and women. I trouble the wakeful with dreams, and I bring to the afflicted voices and visions. When they see what cannot be seen, or hear what is forbidden, or think they have glimpsed some image, some reflection of eternity, then truly it is said that a god is walking beside them.
Who are you?
I am the god, Hermes.
Why do you come?
I come because you have need of me.
Will the child I carry be a boy?
Yes. He will live and grow strong and healthy.
I dream that with his birth my life on earth will end.
You will die the moment he is born.
I am content. Often in my prayers I have offered my life to Zeus, if only Zeus will give me a second son. I did this out of love, for Priam's sake. But Priam does not love me. Lord, tell me this. Will you punish Priam after my death for the way he has treated me?
Is this what you desire, Hecabe?
Yes. But do the gods hear our prayers? Do they listen to our innermost thoughts? Or are the gods themselves and everything they teach only the shadow which the mind casts like a fire when it dreams or sleeps? Priam puts no faith in fate or gods or dreams or prophecies. He says that men stand on the earth, on their own 2 feet, and are master or servant according to their nature. Priam is the greatest king on earth. He has built a city with 12 tall gates and walls of granite which are 15 paces wide. But it was I who gave him the strength to do what had to be done. In the first winter of our marriage, the wooden city which Priam's father had built on the estuary of the river Scamander was sacked by invaders from the Greek mainland. Priam raised an army, and after a single battle, he drove the enemy into the sea. He took no prisoners. They died on the beaches where they stood, or were drowned. Then Priam rebuilt the city. He hardly slept. I had to force him to eat. He shouted, "I am a king, Hecabe, and a king worth the name sees that his men are fed first." I answered, "Without you, there'll be nothing, these people. Eat." And so he ate.
I see that once you loved this man and honored him.
Yes, I loved him then. That year at harvest time, our first child, Hector, was born. Priam nicknamed him Hector the Long-Faced. Hector would laugh. He would not be strange and tongue-tied in his father's presence if Priam spent more time with him. I hoped that if I could give him a second son, then he would love me again as he once did. There was a time when all he lived for was to please me. He taught me how to love him. He wore me like a brooch. But I am no longer young. My brow is lined. My thick black hair will soon be white. Priam has taken from me my youth, my hope, my beauty. Yet in his heart, he knows what all men know. One day he will come back to me, but I will not give him what he needs and wants from me. I will reject him.
Do not weep, Hecabe. The gods love you, and they will deal justly with you. You must not be afraid.
I do not fear death, Lord. Only the pain of dying.
Life is nothing, Hecabe. A bubble upon an ocean of silence. A star in an infinite darkness. Strength, youth, and beauty dissolve into the past and are lost like smoke. But the spirit does not die as a flame dies. It lives and burns forever with a light which is immortal and more brilliant than the sun.
I hear your voice so clearly, Lord. But when I wake, I will forget who you are and what you have said to me.
No, you will not forget. When you wake, Priam will be at your side. You will think this is a dream. But it is not a dream. Remember.
Look, the moon has set, and the cool of the dawn prepares the earth for the day's heat. I watch the walls of the city grow bright as the constellations fade. The Pleiades, Orion, the Great Bear. They melt into the glare like drops of water dissolving upon sand. Hecabe, my beloved wife, is near her time. Each evening, so her women say, she weeps. If she loses the child, it will be my fault. I am Priam. I am king of Troy.
Priam?
I am here, Hecabe. We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.